Yes, that's right. Corey Slee and Sean Jodry are the starters for the Oakdale Bears as they get ready for the player introductions right here at courtside. Once again, you know, the offense, Linganore's offense is averaging, Tom, 69 points per game. They are a shooting, running, and gun run guns offense.
Ought to break out early. Ought to be a fun game to watch up and down the court tonight. And again, they must be playing pretty good defense because they're outscoring their opponents by 23 points a game.
Absolutely. Of course, the defense is stingy, too, only giving up 46 points a game. But unbelievably, Thomas Lang broke his career 1,000-point level back in December on the 8th.
Yes, that's a big milestone, 1,000 points in a high school career. And he's a good, pure scorer. There's no doubt about it. He can score from anywhere on the court.
Yes. And also, I found out yesterday, Lang is committed to a D2 college, Shepherd University, to play ball.
Okay, good for him. Ought to be interesting to see where Jack Staub ends up and what sport he's going to be playing.
Is it?
Yeah, I'd heard Delaware from a couple different people.
So they're keeping the band together.
Yeah, so we'll see what happens.
All right.
And, of course, Tyler Flegel, who's not starting but is a senior on this team, has committed to Army to play football.
Yeah. All right, so on the other side of the equation, Oakdale has only has four seniors on this team. And only six players overall on the team that played on last year's team. So not only do they have a young team, but they've got a fairly inexperienced team this year, and it pretty much shows with their record.
Yeah, definitely young and inexperienced. But watching that JV game, I'll tell you, I mean, it looks like Terry Conley's got himself a good program there. Maybe they have a rough season this season. Yeah, they'll probably be competitive in games. Their win-loss record may not show that. But you got all these kids coming up in the next couple of years. I think Oakdale's going to be good and going to be a contender in this area for a long time.
All right, we'll step aside for our last commercial break before we go to the opening tip-off of this game. You're listening to AM 1450, The Source, and this is going to be a great high school basketball game. Keep it tuned right here. We'll be right back.
Visit the Shamrock today. The Shamrock is located on Route 15, just a mile north of Thurmont. That's the Shamrock Restaurant for good food and some warm Irish hospitality. Tell them WTHU sent you is more fun than a barrel full of leprechauns. That's the Shamrock Restaurant since 1963.
When you mention the mere thought of Ireland in Frederick County, the first thing that springs to mind is the Shamrock Restaurant. Locally owned and operated, the Shamrock Restaurant is a dining legend around the region, featuring Fitzgerald family recipes in the tradition of the Irish countryside. For the Shamrock, it's a continuation of their old country family recipes using fresh, authentic ingredients. Dining in a warm, relaxed atmosphere that you'll remember as a seasonal event. The Shamrock Restaurant, located just north of Thurmont on Route 15. Stop by today and find out why it's the most popular restaurant in our area for over 30 years. The Shamrock
All
Restaurant.
Right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are ready for the opening tip-off of this game. Both teams are in the circle and we're ready to go. There it is, up in the air, and Oakdale comes up with it. So Oakdale will open with possession at the left side of the court. Down on the left wing, they take a peek underneath and nothing's there. They back it around and work the other side on the right side. Right wing drives down, pulls up, shoots a 20-footer, nothing but net. Good shot by number 34, Sean McGackie, to open it up.
Yeah, and I expect this Oakdale Bears team to be pumped up. And you can see McGackie running down the court. He was pumped up to make that shot and give him a 2-0 lead early in this game.
Lang takes a shot from deep in the corner, misses it, and then the loose ball comes up with it. Number 5, Carter Schmidt, and they bring it out front to Staub. Jack has it. Passes to Lang. Lang out on the top, does a spin move straight in, right hand off the glass, and scores on a beautiful move to the bucket.
Again, quickly knotted up, and the kid can score from anywhere. You can't give him room outside, but you can't let him dribble drive either.
Here comes Oakdale back the other way, down on the right side. They bounce pass underneath to give and go, and he scores. Horning down low with the bucket.
It looks like Oakdale may be trying to push that ball inside against these Linganore Lancers tonight.
Nicholas Lang with the ball back to Jack Staub. Staub down the Lang in the corner on the left side. He brings it out to Lang, and now we've got a whistle away from the ball. It's going to be a foul on Oakdale. First personal is going to go on number 10.
Yeah, Brad Foster, first personal foul.
Leonard inbound from underneath their own basket. Lang wide open underneath number 25.
25, Harry Rasmussen.
Harry Rasmussen.
Doesn't get any easier than that. Defensive breakdown by the Bears on that play.
Now we've got a foul at this end, and that one's going to go on Rasmussen at the other end. You know, Rasmussen, who was the guy that wore the headband last year on Linganore? What was his name, you remember?
I can't recall. I
Rasmussen
remember seeing
must have
it, yeah.
stolen his headband because he's got it on. You know who I'm talking about, right?
I do.
Yeah. I'll have to find that out on the break. There's a shot from 15 foot, no good. Staub comes up with the rebound. Staub looking down court, nothing there. So he slows it up and holds it. He turns around and passes over to Carter Schmidt. Carter Schmidt back to Jack. Jack goes up with a left hander off the glass. Too hard, put back is no good. And Oakdale rips the rebound down. Here comes Oakdale on the transition, running him out. He backs it out, holds up, and they reset. Down on the right wing, Brad Foster has it. Foster guarded by Lang. Back out front, shot from three-point land, short off the front of the iron, rebound, Linganore.
Yeah, and again, when the ball's in Lang's hands or Staub's hands, they're going to dribble drive, look for penetration, look to either dish it out or take it right to the hole.
Well, they're giving him that lane. He's got a seam down the lane on every time. Working the perimeter, Nicholas Lang hands off to Thomas. Again, a spin move underneath, stolen. Oakdale, good defense as they trap in the lane.
Yeah, a little soft on the pass inside. Let Oakdale step right in front of that one.
4-4, tie score here in the first. And now we've got a five-second violation.
That's yeah, you can't hold the ball like that. You got to do something with it. You got to play with purpose out there.
Yep.
If Linganore is going to get in your face, and they are a defensive team, you got to be able to get that ball, pass it, or dribble drive.
McGackie with the turnover violation. Nicholas Lang down on the left wing, passes to Thomas in the corner. He shoots from 20 foot, too hard off the back iron. Ball's up in the air, tip rebound. Nicholas Lang, Jack Staub from way out front, no good. Rebound again. Linganore has it. Lang shoots again, swish.
There you go, another two-pointer. Lang, top of the key. And again, Linganore doing a great job on the boards. They made a lot of opportunities there. Four second-chance opportunities there to get the basket.
That's three straight offensive rebounds by the Lancers to convert. Oakdale has it. Cross-court shot. Woo-hoo, nothing but net. Number 42 drains it.
Sean Godfrey.
From the corner, Staub shoots short. Oh, it gets a good bounce, and there's a whistle. It hit the front of the iron, popped straight up in the air, and went through the net.
Got the home team bounce on that one, but again, hey, that wire is out of bounds.
Yes, he stepped on the line, so it's going to be no basket. An Oakdale ball. Oakdale with their first lead of the game, 7-6 now, with 3:42 to go in the first. High post to McGackie. McGackie harassed by Rasmussen, kicks it back out front. Top of the key. They work the other side, stolen by Lang. Here comes Thomas, he'll go all the way with it up off the glass, and he scores. You can't stop him when he wants to go to the hoop, Tom.
Yeah, and it looks like Linganore is going to be pushing the ball up and down the court in this game. Looks like Oakdale's trying to be a little bit more patient on their offensive end. McGackie, top of the key, calls the play.
Linganore takes the lead back, 8-7. Oakdale with the ball. They post Schley out front. Down on the right wing to McGackie. Bounce pass underneath. Shot to score. Number 44 puts it through the hoop, Corey Schley. Good bounce feed by McGackie there. Here comes Little Lang. He goes, oh, a scoop shuffle shot, and he makes it.
Scoop-de-doo on that one. Hey, you got the tail of two teams here. You got Linganore, it's a slashing team, and Oakdale just wants to be patient and punch it inside to their big guys. They think they outsize Linganore on the inside and in the interior, so they're going to try and drop down there all game long.
Oakdale with the ball down by one. Over here on the right wing, Schley has it. Guarded by Rasmussen. He kicks it back out front. They work other side. Looking around that perimeter down in the left corner now. Good defense by Linganore. Playing man defense. There's a shot from out front. So whiff. Nothing but net. Three-pointer for McGackie to retake the lead.
Yeah, 12-10 Oakdale. So Oakdale's not going to go away easily here.
Lang comes back the other way with his own answer, but it does not go, and Oakdale comes up with a lead.
Yeah, Linganore looks like they're getting a lot of opportunities, but they're looking like they're cold tonight. Their shots are not dropping.
Down on the left wing, Oakdale has it. 12-10. There's a shot from three-point land the other way. No good. Rebound, Nicholas Lang. Lang brings it up the right side. Banks pass to Rasmussen. Back to Lang. He takes a look at the shot. Nothing there. Cross court to Schmidt. Schmidt shoots the tray. No good. Rebound Oakdale.
Yeah, Lancers haven't seen a three-pointer they didn't like yet, have they? They're not dropping, but they're certainly not shy about taking those shots.
Sean Dodry on the right wing. They work the other side of the perimeter all the way back around. Good ball movement by the Bears. Corey Schley posts the shot from three-point land short off the front of the rim. Rebound, Linganore. Schmidt comes up with Lang with a long cross-court pass to Nicholas Lang. Drive to the hoop. Underneath, gets caught. Steps on the line. Jack Staub loses it to Oakdale.
Staub loses out of bounds. We're going to have a couple of substitutions for Linganore. Number 50 is coming in. He's going to spell Rasmussen. And you've got number 3, Austin Lonai, in the game.
So Keegan Lane comes in to the game for his first minutes on the floor. Down on the left wing, Oakdale, drive to the bucket, pull-up shot. Shot, swish, nothing but net. What a great shot by number 2, Tyler Horning, on the fadeaway.
And Horning hot coming in off a 22-point effort in their last game out.
15-foot fadeaway by Horning gives Oakdale the biggest lead of the game, 14-10, with 15 seconds on the clock in this first period. Looks like now we've got a whistle. What was the call on that, Tom?
Call on that is 5 seconds again. Just dribbling it out
there. Wasn't
no
being guarded, though. He wasn't guarded, though.
He was guarded. The referee did indicated that was going to be the case.
Yeah.
And he was just out there without a purpose, just dribbling the ball. They were looking to run the clock down and take the last shot.
In all fairness, without a shot clock in boys varsity basketball, you got to have a good five-second call. Oakdale has it off the screen. Shot from the top of the key. Loose ball. Oakdale comes up with a putback. There's a hurry. No good. And that's the end of the first period with the Oakdale Bears 14 and the Linganore Lancers 10. We'll take a quick break and be right back.
Emerson once said, people only see what they are prepared to see. That's why Thermont Eye Care understands that vision is more than just seeing. It is providing you with professional vision solutions from eyewear to contacts that will help you see better and enhance how people see you. Thermont Eye Care is passionate about providing for all of your vision needs with a caring attitude and a dedicated commitment to serving those who want the best. Conveniently located on the square in Thermont, Maryland. Thermont Eye Care can help you save time and money. Tired of driving all over just to find the right vision care center that can fit your busy schedule? Dr. Molly Care is a board-certified optometrist with years of experience who understands that your eyesight is a precious gift. See the best. Thermont Eye Care. Located at number 2 East Main Street in downtown Thermont. Walk in or call area code 301-271-0554 for an appointment today. That number again, 301-271-0554.
That's Thermont Eye Care, one of the proud sponsors of tonight's game. We're ready for the inbound for this second period of action, and there it is. Lang has it. Thomas Lang in the middle of the circle, top of the key to Tyler Flegel. He drives off the pick and roll. They look. They work it around the other side. We've got a whistle. Going to be an offensive call. A foul against Linganore.
It's going to be on the big guy inside, number 42, Tyler Flegel. Looked like a little bit too much muscle on that pick.
Yep. Flegel gets the call. His first personal in the game. And Oakdale gets the ball with a four-point lead. Down court on the right side to Horning. Horning, they work around the perimeter to the other side now, on the left. Cross court pass. Sean Jodry takes the tray. Swish! So Jodry hits his second tray of the game to extend the lead to five, and all of a sudden, Linganore kind of back on their heels. Lang drives the baseline, pulls up, shoots a shorty, and misses. Loose ball, rebound, Bears come up with it.
Yet again, so far tonight, Linganore has been cold. I know they like to push the ball, and I like to get to the basket quick, but their shots are just not dropping, which equates to a seven-point lead for Oakdale, which is surprising here early in the second quarter.
Horning down here in the corner on the right side. Jodry fakes the three, kicks it back to Horning. He drives off the pick. Again off the second pick. Bounce pass gets away from him, and it goes over to Linganore.
Yeah, good defense there. They pressured Horning, and he made the mistake. He cracked and just passed out of bounds. I don't know who he's throwing it to. He's trying to get it inside, but
Linganore has got to work their offense now and stop trying to improvise. They work around the perimeter, out the lane, up high. Thomas drives off the screen. He pulls up and shoots the three. No good. Rebound, Oakdale. So there's the story of this first half. Lang having a cold first half. Drive to the hoop and a score for Horning. 9-point lead for the Bears at 6:13.
And Linganore with four substitutions in the game now, and Thomas Lang. And there they go.
Underneath the lane, he scores. Lang hits him on the run. A jump pass, and Lane puts it in. The first 2 points in this second period for the Lancers.
And good things happen when you go to the basket looking to, you know, either take the clear shot or looking for a cutter, and he found a cutter. I think Linganore needs to look to pass first in this offense and get the ball moving around.
Horning shoots the tray and misses. Lane goes up high for the rebound, picks it off the ceiling, and kicks it out to Thomas Lang, down in the corner. Number three, Austin Lanis in the game. And Oakdale steals the ball. They come up with it.
Good pass inside to Flegel. He just wasn't ready for it.
Horning, top of the key, guarded by Lanis. Right wing to Jodry. Jodry has it tipped away. Good D by Flegel. Quick hands for a big man.
Yeah, he's an athletic kid for his size. He's extremely athletic.
Well, he used those quick hands in a football game I remember last year where he blocked the crucial extra point to win the game.
I coached him as a freshman. He's got a motor that does not stop.
All right, here we go. Oakdale having a little trouble inbounding with the Linganore crew cheering away here. He's got to make some room there. Here it comes. They got it in. Into Connor Givens, underneath, reverse layup, no good, rebound, strong off the boards, Carter Schmidt. Puts it out to Lang, underneath to Schmidt. Schmidt drives, goes up off the glass with the right-hander and scores.
And Linganore needs to do a little more of that. Get that ball inside, get those easy buckets, get a couple under your belt, get that confidence up and start changing momentum here.
Linganore trims the lead to 5, 19-14. Oakdale on top. They have the ball. Down on the left wing now. Driving into the paint. Pulls up, looking for help. Nothing there. Kicks it out to Jodry. Jodry shoots the tray. High off the glass, no good. Carter Schmidt rips the tip back, and they kick it back out to Nicholas Lang. Nicholas plays catch with brother Thomas. Thomas hits Schmidt on the cutter, but he loses it off his foot. Linganore comes up with it. Cross court to Jack Staub. Staub off the pick. Staub and Lang play catch. Staub goes to the hoop. Fade away on the right hander. Does not go. Rebound Bears.
And again, that's not the shot they wanted. They don't want Staub taking a fade away. They want him going strong to the basket, get fouled, get a good bucket. If they're going to play like that, it could be a long night and keep Oakdale in this game.
Oakdale with the ball now, top of the key. As Givens posts up. Givens over to Ziegler. Ziegler now in the game, working around the perimeter. They go back to the left side now. Gibbons fakes the shot. Guarded by Lane, he kicks it over to McGackie. McGackie turns. McGackie, harassed by Schmidt, gets in trouble. Long cross-court pass. Drive on the run, does not go. Loose ball foul. That one's going to go on Schmidt, I think.
That's going to go against Oakdale. Schmidt, good position Oakdale, yeah. Underneath, yeah.
So they put that one on Ziegler.
That's going to be the second team foul, so no worries there. Keegan Lane is going to inbound to Thomas Lang. And with 3:02, Oakdale leading here at Linganore by 5 points, 19-14.
So they put 54 up on the screen, which means that was Gibbons who drew the foul, his first personal. Linganore has it. Lane, spin move, and he travels. Oh, my goodness. The big center tried to get fancy and act like a guard.
Had too many feet on that one, right? Too many steps. I think Coach Kraft over there telling him, hey, you got to calm down. You got to play our game. Don't try to do too much. So we get you the ball, we're going to get it to you right inside underneath the basket.
Pulls him out of the game. Rasmussen back in, subbing out. Lane. Oh, stolen by Lang. Lang has a breakaway, 1-on-3. He goes all the way off the glass and scores. That's Thomas Lang at his finest.
Yeah, keeping them single-handedly in the game. 19-16, they're within three now.
2:20 to go in the half. The Bears have it up by three. Down on the left side. They work around the perimeter to the right side now. Looking for the screen. One bounce. Bounce pass underneath. Nothing there. He kicks it back out front. Now they go around and work the left side of the perimeter. Always looking underneath. Looking inside. Tipped away by Lang.
And again, Linganore up in the ante here on defense. They're playing pretty good aggressive defense now. Steal by Thomas Lang last time. Nick Lang almost had one there. But Oakdale continues to be patient. And it seems like that's their game plan coming in.
Got a sub in the game now. Drew Jazario in the game now. Tyler Horning has it. Down on the left side. Jazario has it. Offensive foul. Was that a three-point violation in the lane?
No, that was a foul on Sean Jodry. Pushing off on the inside.
Right. His first personal, third team foul on the Bears. Linganore has it. Stolen by Linganore. Jazario has it. He's trying to go up against Schmidt, but he blocks him out. They back it out and reset. Connolly calls the play from the bench, and now you've got a whistle. We're going to have a blocking foul. It's going to be on Linganore.
They're going to call that on Lang.
Yep.
So both teams with three team fouls here.
They called it on Nicholas Lang. Oh, yeah.
Half.
Okay. And now we've got a whistle on the opposite side of the court. And another foul, this one on Oakdale, and it's going to go against number 44, Corey Schley. So a very physical game so far in this first half, Tom.
Yeah, interesting. No whistles early on, and now a flurry of whistles here as we get inside a minute here to go in the first half.
Lang goes to the hoop, tries to dish it off, loses the ball, and there's a shot and a foul, and our first free throw of the game. All the way almost to the halftime without a single free throw, Rasmussen will walk up to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, Rasmussen with the long hair and the headband, almost like a throwback, like a Jack Sigma kind of look, huh?
Yeah. He misses the front end. Off to the right a little bit, off the iron, bounces left. Number 25, big kid. 6'4", junior, makes the second one. Two-point game now, 19-17, Oakdale. Linganore's managed to peck away at that lead in this second period.
Yeah, they're eating the apple one bite at a time here. Right now they're looking to get it tied up, and then hopefully, they want to play their game in the second half. It's going to wind down here with 55 seconds to go.
Taylor puts on a clinic out front and dribbling. Tyler Horning tries to work it underneath, but they lose it. But Oakdale gets it back. Lang goes for the steal unsuccessfully. Shot from 3 points. So whiffs. What an arc by number 44, Corey Slee.
It drew rain on that one. Old rainbow jumper there. Three-pointer to put him back up by five.
28 seconds on the clock. Lang has it. Down by five. Looks like they're going to work for the last bucket, Tom.
Yeah, unless there's a five-second call here. It looks like Lang's going to run it down and try and dribble drive and make something happen.
Down to nine, eight, seven, six. There goes Lang. Spin, turns, pulls up, ditches it off. Double pump. Shot by Rasmussen. Doesn't go, but he's fouled.
Yeah, and if I was Oakdale on the inside, every time Rasmussen gets it in there, I wouldn't go for the first one because you know he's going to pump fake you, get you up. He gets to the line pretty efficiently.
So Rasmussen makes the first one, trims the lead to four, 2.4 seconds to go in the first half. And it rattles in and out. Oakdale comes up with a chance for a long downcourt shot. Hits the iron way above the basket glass. And that's the end of the first half of action here. Surprisingly, the Oakdale Bears 22, the Linganore Lancers 18. We'll take a quick break and we'll wrap up our first half before we head out for our music break.
We're all busy with plenty of commitments. That's why Anytime Fitness is the perfect way to stay in shape. From either home or work, Anytime Fitness of Thurmont is always close by, and they're open 24/7. They can tailor a personalized training program to fit your workout needs. Anytime Fitness can also fashion a membership and payment plan that will be flexible enough for your on-the-go lifestyle. You'll love the 24-hour co-ed fitness center with state-of-the-art equipment designed to sculpt and tone you into shape. And when you're away from the Thurmont area, your membership guarantees you access to any of the over 1,000 clubs worldwide. Visit us at 130 Frederick Road to start your program today. Now you can stay healthy anytime with Anytime Fitness.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Courtside, where the Oakdale Bears are leading 22-18 here on the floor with a great basketball game so far. I want to thank our sponsors who made this first half possible, Anytime Fitness of Thurmont, Frederick County Bank, Med One Pharmacy, Shamrock Restaurant, and Thurmont Eye Care. Thanks for sponsoring tonight's Central Maryland Spires Division 3A West matchup between the Linganore Lancers and the Oakdale Bears. Tom, what was your analysis? What was the difference in that first half? It's only a four-point game right now.
Yeah, it is only a four-point game, Michael. It's interesting. 22-18, Oakdale in front. Not what we expected coming in tonight. 3-5, Oakdale Bear team taking on a juggernaut offensive team of Linganore Lancers, who are 8-0 at this point and scoring 69 points per game. And at 18 points right now, they're held well below their average. So a couple of things. I think Linganore's gotten out of their game. I think they're trying to do a little bit too much one-on-one. Dribble drive, they're not looking to make the pass, get the assist. But I would also say on the Oakdale side, I think they came in with a game plan. That game plan was let's be patient, let's move the ball around the perimeter, and let's get really good shots, and let's try and work the ball inside. And they've done that effectively. And they've got timely three-pointers from guys like Corey Schley and Horning and McGackie. So I think if Oakdale continues to play within that game plan, they could give Linganore some fits unless Linganore reacts and changes their plan up and gets back into that motion offense and moving the ball and getting up and down the floor quickly, but under control. I think they were out of control a little bit here in the first half, and I think they took Oakdale for granted a little bit.
So you think Kraft's going to tell them in the dressing room, it's our game to take, we just got to settle down and work our offense?
Yeah, just like I would. Hey, we got them right where we want them.
All right, that's it. We're going to step aside for a little halftime music mix for you. We'll be back in about 7 minutes to start the opening inbound of the third quarter.
Head out on the highway, looking for adventure, and whatever comes our way, yeah, I gotta go make it happen, take the world in a loving embrace,
racing with the wind. We can fly so high, I never wanna die. fast she was, just walking down the street singing. Tapping her fingers and shuffling her feet singing. She looked good. She looked fine. She looked good. She looked fine. And I nearly lost my mind. Before I knew it, she was walking next to me singing. Holding my hand just as natural as can be singing. We walk on to my door. We walk on to my door. Then we kissed a little more. Oh, I knew we was falling in love. Yes, I did, and so I told her all the things I'd been dreaming of. Now we're together.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to courtside here at Linganore High School, where the Bears have a 22-18 lead, and they've just inbounded with possession in the opening salvo of this third period. There's a shot from the corner, no good, short off the front of the rim. Linganore rebound, straight to the hoop, double pump, Nicholas Lang is fouled. So yeah. Little Lang will go to the free throw line.
And that's the way they need to attack this Oakdale. Deliberate, get to the basket, not dribble drive one-on-one. You can see they spread the wings. They got it up to Nicholas Lang, and he got a good layup, fouled on the play. First half stats, interestingly enough, Thomas Lang with 8 points as Nicholas makes the first end of two foul shots. Schmidt has four, Rasmussen has four. And then on the Oakdale side, even scoring across the board, Schley with seven, Jodry with six, McGackie with five, and Horning with four. And now it's quickly a two-point game.
So he makes both of them, Nicholas Lang, but he makes both free throws to trim it to two now. The Bears have it. Corey Schley, top of the key. Down on the left wing, back to Schley now. Schley drives, pulls up, shoots on the run, no good, tipped away. The Bears come up with it. Goes back in, shoots off the glass, and he's fouled. Rasmussen's going to get that one.
Yeah, it looked like he went straight up and down, but again, when some of his contact inside, particularly in a high school game, you're going to get that call most of the time anyway. So Schley goes to the line to shoot two, with Oakdale leading 22-20.
Second personal on Rasmussen.
Nothing but net for Schley. For a big guy, he's got a nice touch. He hit an early rainbow jumper toward the end of the second half, or first half. Nothing but net. Both free throws, nothing but net. He's got a nice stroke for a big guy.
Good touch. Here comes Lang. Between the leg dribble, he drives down on the left side. Shoots it in and moves across. Here comes McGackie with the ball. He brings it up. He does a little between the leg dribble himself, guarded by Schmidt. Down on the left wing. Back around the perimeter. They work the right side now. Horning comes up and sets the pick. And they go to McGackie. He drives the lane, bounce pass out to the corner. Shot from the corner, short off the front of the rim, loose ball. And it looks like Nicholas Lang hits the floor and is fouled.
So Jodry on the foul. Thomas Lang brings the ball up court.
Lang to Staub. Staub drives off the pick. Double clutch, layup, doesn't go. Loose ball tipped away by Linganore. Oakdale comes up with it. Here comes Horning with it. He drives the paint, pulls up, gets a double, triple team. And then they kick it out on the left wing and take their time, slow it up a bit. Godry with the ball. McGackie down on the right side. He turns, drives left, and now we've got a foul underneath.
Yeah, it looks like they may call that on number four, Nicholas Lang reaching in as McGackie drove into the key.
24-20, Bears by four with 6:04 in the third. Ball's out on the right side now. Bounce pass underneath. Wide open. Shot off the glass. Corey Schley makes it look easy. Thomas Lang underneath. Rasmussen fakes a shot and then shoots and scores, and he's fouled. So Rasmussen will go to the line to try to make it three the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, earning it. For sure, earning it in there. And Rasmussen hits the free throw as well. So Lingador, 26-23. 5:46 to go here. Oakdale brings the ball across midcourt. Thomas Lang on the defense. Falls out to Horning. Nicholas Lang on the defense. Horning drives. Loses the ball. Out to Ziegler. And McGackie at the top of the key. McGackie dribble drive to the right. Off to Ziegler. Ziegler tries to get the ball inside to Schley. And it looks like they're going to call number 25, Rasmussen, on the foul there. Pushing on the inside.
So that's four team fouls now on the Bears. No, three on Lingenor, four on the Bears. And that's going to be an inbound by the Bears
in the first half. And here we are with 3-3 here in the second half early.
Oh, a lob inside to number 44, Schley. And in the air, he puts it through the hoop. The first real test of this young season for these Lingenor Lancers. Wide open underneath.
Connor Schmidt, number five. And that's what Lingenor needs to do. They need to keep their head up and they need to look for the open man, because they're gonna collapse on Lang. And if Lang can find the open man, they're going to get a lot of easy buckets.
Lang hit him with a laser underneath. They're tipped away. Loose ball. Lingenor's got it on the steal. Schmidt out to Lang. Lang going straight up the middle of the court. Pulls up at the foul line. Kicks it back to Schmidt. Over to Nicholas Lang. Nicholas Lang to Thomas. Thomas fakes the shot, dribbles left, down in the corner, drives the baseline, pulls up, loses the ball to Oakdale. Good defense by the Bears.
Yeah, they painted themselves into a corner there, and again, got in trouble. He had nowhere to go with the basketball, and the Oakdale collapsed on him.
Down on the right side, Horning. Bounce pass underneath. McGackie goes up in the air. Loose ball up in the air, tipped away. Lingenor almost comes over there with a step on the line. It'll be Oakdale ball.
Yeah, and Oakdale getting the ball inside early here. They're trying to feed Schley on the inside, just like they did on that lob pass. And they're getting all the extra chance opportunities here in the second half. Try to get it into Schley again.
Schley goes up with a right-hander, and he's fouled. It's going to go on Lane, which is going to send Schley to the line to shoot two, with his team up by three and 4:14 on the clock in the third.
And from what I've seen early in this game, putting Schley on the line is like 2 points. Smooth touch. And as soon as I say that, I'm going to jinx him probably. First one again, nothing but net.
Swish, right up in the air. Nice rainbow free throw. Good arc. Good distance. Perfect foul shooting technique. Again.
Yep, nothing
it's like
but
he's
net.
Just, he's like a shooting robot, a free throw robot.
Yeah, and too many people don't shoot those well.
Down on the left side, Staub has it on the left wing. He drives, pulls up, off the glass. And it does not go. Jack having a terrible night.
He attacked that basket hard. That was a good effort there, but just did not fall for him. Horning at top of the tee, dribble drive on Lang. Off the Schley with Keegan Lane covering.
Down on the
out
right
to
corner.
DeZorio. Into Schley, back out to
DeZorio. There's a shot from way out front, air ball. Lingenor comes up with it. Carter Schmidt on the run. Transition bucket underneath. Lane, right hand finger roll, scores.
And now Lingenor down by three, 30-27 with 3:25 to go here in the third quarter.
Oakdale with it. Horning, little contact between him and Lang. He drives up, pumps it out, tries to pass it underneath. Tipped away, stolen by Lingenor. Here comes Lang, bounce pass on the run to Staub. Staub with the right hander off the glass, and this time it's good.
And Lingenor moving the ball really, really well on the transition game here. A couple easy buckets in a row, and now it's 30-29. And Coach Terry Conley has seen enough. He wants to call a timeout and settle his guys down.
That'll give us an opportunity to take a quick timeout ourselves. We'll be right back after this important commercial message.
You've seen a superhero lately? Frederick County superheroes are all around us, making a difference in the lives of others on a daily basis. Hi, I'm Betsy Day, president of the Community Foundation of Frederick County. I'm honored to know hundreds of superheroes who changed lives through scholarships and grants. You can be a superhero too by creating your legacy with the Community Foundation. I'd love to talk with you. There's no obligation. Just call me at 301-695-7660. Again, that's 301-695-7660, or visit our website at frederickcountygives.org.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Oakdale has the ball and the lead, but only by 1 point.
Lingenor continuing to whittle away at that lead that Oakdale took into the dressing room at the half. Good man defense by the Lancers. Oh, and the ball turned over. A three-on-one break. Jack Staub's got it. He goes up off the glass and blocking foul on Oakdale. Jack's going to go to the line and shoot two.
And that's what Staub needs to do. He needs to go to the basket strong like that. He got a blocking foul on Schlesch, so he's going to be there shooting two.
I thought he might have traveled on that.
I was wondering if he didn't lower his head and was going to go the other way, but Lingenor got a good call there for them.
Staub
misses
short
the first
off the
one.
Front of the iron, misses the first one.
So 2:32 to go here, and Staub not having a good shooting night.
Yeah, he's having a bad night, really.
But he's got an opportunity here to tie the game.
Jack to shoot one, nothing but net. Tie game, 30 apiece. Oakdale inbounds. DeZorio brings it up. Down on the right wing. Double team, they draw it, and there's a whistle. They're calling a lot now. They're getting in the game. Referee's going to get a foul on that one. That's five team fouls now.
Yeah, the call is on Staub as McGackie tried to dribble around the right sideline to the baseline.
That was on Staub, his first personal.
They're going to keep the game close now. They're going to call a lot.
Oakdale inbounds. Gezioro has it out at the top of the key, down on the right wing. Schley posts outside. McGackie drives the paint, pulls up, shoots it, rattles in and out. He gets his own putback. Beautiful play by McGackie. Now Lingenor loses the ball out of bounds. A turnover to Oakdale.
Yeah, Connor Schmidt ahead of his teammates there. Not a whole lot he could do with the ball except he tried to get a shot off, but dribbled it off his leg and out of bounds. So 32-30 with 1:54 to go in the third.
What a great game we've got here for you tonight. Gezioro spins, fires it across court. Stolen by Nicholas Lang. One on two, he goes straight up with it. Misses, put back, no good. Second put back, no good. Lingenor rebound. Carter Smith throws it away.
Yeah, he's got to play a little bit more under control. Tried to get that ball in there too quickly. They made a good play to get the ball back. But again, just a wasted opportunity for Lingenor. Down 32-30 here with 1:33 to go. Oakdale brings the ball up court. Out to DeZorio. Lang on DeZorio. Out to McGackie and around the horn. They're moving the ball good on the perimeter here.
Another whistle. Let's see who the call is. It's going to go against Oakdale. And it's on number two, Tyler Horning, his second personal now.
And a host of substitutions here.
Yeah.
Michael Reinick.
Coach Kraft is going to platoon in
for the last bench. Minute 22 here. Get some fresh legs for the fourth quarter. So you got number two, Michael Reinick, a guard. You got number three, Austin Lone Eyes, and the big guy, number 42, Tyler Flegel in.
The coaching chess match goes now in substitutions between these two great coaches. Down on the left wing, Staub has it. Drives, pulls, turns, spins, on the move. He fades and shoots, no good. Rebound, Lingenor. Jack fakes the shot, goes to the hoop again. This time, fingertip roll, scores.
There you go, and that's how he's got to play. He's got to play strong. None of the fadeaway game. Just take the ball to the hoop. He's bigger and faster and stronger than a lot of these kids out here tonight. 32-32 with 56 seconds to go here in the third.
Now we've got a whistle off the glass, no good. He's pointing down underneath. We've got a foul. Yeah. Blocking foul on Lingenor. Oakdale ball. I believe that is the sixth team foul on Lingenor. They've only got one to give now.
It is. Number two, Michael Reinick there. And it's ticky-tack foul time. They're calling everything now.
Underneath. Left-hander off the glass and a score on the inbound. Jodry gets it. Lang from the key shoots and scores. Swish. Tie game. What a back-and-forth basketball game we've got here tonight.
34 all, 33 seconds to go here. Lingenor pressuring the ball. Lang on the ball.
Brad Foster back in the game now. Passes down on the right side to Schley. Schley holds the ball. Not guarded, so there's no count yet. No count yet. They're backing off, looking for that last. Down to 10 seconds, waiting for that last shot. And there it is, it's on Flegel, blocking foul. That is the seventh, so that's going to send
Schley to the line to shoot the 1-1 bonus.
It's going to put him in the bonus, and it's the last guy you want on the line, Mr. Nothing But Net.
He's a
so with 4.3
That's the last guy on
go,
the court you want to foul.
35 feet from the hoop, and you get a blocking foul. It's the last thing you want to do. Two defensive breakdowns there in a row. Lingenor let the inbound pass in right underneath the basket for an easy bucket, and then a blocking foul so far from the basket.
Crowd's getting it on him. So wish.
First time he hit the rim all night, but still. Puts it in. Oakdale up 35-34 here with 4.3 to go.
And that one rattles and drops.
So,
oh!
He had the buzzer.
At the buzzer, three-point shot.
Three-pointer.
37-36, and I heard a whistle on that, so there may be a foul shot to come to put Lingenor up by two instead of one. So Lang shoots a tray. No, they gave him two, but he's going to go to the line for the bonus penalty shot now to try to take the lead for the first time in the second half. Boom! He nails it.
And they do. And Lang, greeted by his teammates, here we go. This could be the burst that Lingenor needed to get going here in the fourth quarter. They ate away at that lead slowly but surely, and now they're leading 37-36. What a turn of events here as the quarter ended, though.
What a great, you'd think it was Friday night with the crowd and the excitement and the way this is going, and this is Tuesday night. You know what? These two teams are going to meet again in exactly a month on the 5th of February, and that's a Friday night at Oakdale.
Okay.
Imagine what that's going to be like.
Oh, it's going to be electric there. It's electric here tonight, believe it, on a Tuesday night.
Yeah.
So it'll be a quick break here in the quarter, and we're going to get right back into this action.
Well, we got 8 minutes up on the clock, a one-point lead for Lingenor, and it's going to be basically going to be a foot race to the finish line.
Yeah, and it'll be interesting to see how both these teams play. Lingenor should probably continue to push the ball, and Oakdale is going to be patient. They're going to try and get the ball into Schley. Schley's been the guy for them here in the second half.
What was the biggest lead of the game so far? 4 points, maybe five at the most?
About 5 points.
Yeah.
Oh, 7 points, 19-12 early Oakdale.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Right at the very beginning, right. All right, here we go. Lingenor will get the ball to start out this last fourth period of action here. The referee's talking to Coach Connolly over the far side, motioning and pointing to the other referee. And now we're ready. Inbound to Lang. Lang brings it up. Lang kicks it out. They're working a bit of a weave there. Nicholas Lang with the ball. He drives off the screen. They roll on the screen, nothing there. Lane posts up. Down on the right side, Schmidt drives, pulls up, shoots off the glass, no good. Rebound, Nicholas Lang. Lingenor has it. Shot from the corner, no good. Rebound. Bears have it. Corey Schley pulls it down. We're back-to-back misses by Lingenor, and the Bears bring it up court, down by one.
And again, the Bears being patient here, moving the ball around. They're going to try and get it into Schley or McGackie's hands.
McGackie back to Jodry. Jodry to McGackie. They play catch. Hits him on the run. Straight off the glass. Misses. Rebound. Lang. Nicholas Lang with the ball, brings it up. Head fake, rolls, kicks it out to his brother. Right in front of the scorer's table, Thomas has it. Thomas drives the paint, double clutch, shot off the glass, and it drops.
He's looking to take over this game, and he was motioning to his brother earlier when his brother was bringing the ball up court. Come on, move it. He wants to pick the pace up and be frenetic here.
39-36, straight to the hoop. Whoa! Lane shuts him down, knocks him to the floor. He's still on the ground. Who was that?
The drove. That was Horning going into where the big guys are. And Keegan Lane looks like he got up and got the basketball. It did, you know, he may have had some contact there, but it looked like the momentum of grabbing the basketball, not necessarily blocking it, took him to the ground. He hit the ground hard.
The call is on Keegan, his second personal. Horning is still on the floor. He is right in the three second lane
in the paint right underneath the basket on Oakdale's side and Oakdale's backcourt. And both teams respectfully huddle up with an injured player on the floor. That'll give us an opportunity to thank our sponsors for making tonight's game possible. Anytime Fitness of Thurmont. Get your New Year's resolution groove going at Anytime Fitness today. Frederick County Bank, the greatest bank in Frederick. Med One Pharmacy has three locations in Thurmont, Emmitsburg, and Middletown. And the historic Shamrock Restaurant for the best Irish food in the region. Check out the Shamrock. And finally, last but not least, Thurmont Eye Care. Dr. Molly Karen and her staff will take great care of you and all your eye care needs. Thanks for sponsoring tonight's 3A West CMC Spires Division matchup between the Linganore Lancers and the Oakdale Bears. And we're here at courtside, and the player, Horning, is on his side, laying on the floor still. Now Coach Connolly comes out. It doesn't look good.
Yeah, Coach's been out there the whole time. Horning's smacked the ground a few times. To me, I can't tell what they're looking at. It looks like they're looking at his knee, but to me, it looked like he hit his hip really hard when he hit the ground.
Like a hip pointer or something like that. But they've got athletic director Sonny Joseph here for Linganore is out there with him now helping, and they're trying to decide what to do. He looks like he's in a lot of pain. So tell you what, we're going to step aside for a short break, take a commercial, and step aside as they sort this one out. We'll be right back.
If you own a business, you know that work doesn't begin and end with the hours posted on your door. Hi, this is Business Development Officer Mary Berry, and at Frederick County Bank, we understand that too. That's why we make business banking easy and accessible, anytime, anywhere. From BuzzPoint Merchant Reward and Loyalty to online banking, remote deposit capture to business courier service, Frederick County Bank, Frederick's true community bank, is open for business, anytime, anywhere. Contact me at 301-620-1400 and online at fcbmd.com. Member FDIC.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are still in an injury timeout, a protracted one at that, as the trainers administer to Tyler Horning.
It looks like he's starting to roll over. They're being very gentle with him there. It looks like he may be getting up. I saw one of the Linganore High School administrators talking to the ground.
It's his left knee. You can see right now, he can't put any pressure on that left leg at all as his teammates walk out to help. They're going to help carry him to the bench. Yeah, he's dragging that leg.
Yeah, and he's not a big guy to begin with. He's a slender kid. Almost a little bit on the bonier side. So you can tell when you hit that, there's not a lot of meat and muscle there to protect those bones. And you know, hit hard.
Let's just hope it's hard. Like a bruised kneecap or something like that, you know.
Or just a deep contusion or something.
Right.
It's still painful, but it's a lot less to deal with than...
Right. He's putting a little weight on it now, but they're going to take him into the dressing room.
Yeah, he's having a hard time sitting, so I think it is the hip.
So the first free throw by Ziegler, he misses, and he makes the second one. So we're back to a two-point game. Linganore has the ball and the lead. Lang brings it up, cross court. Nicholas Lang down in the corner to Staub. They work the other side back to Thomas. Thomas, he loses the ball out of bounds, but it goes off of Oakdale. So Linganore will retain possession.
Yeah, I think he got away with one there. It looked like he threw the ball out of bounds, and the referee on the other side just happened to call it that way.
Bounce pass to Carter Schmidt underneath. Jump shot, no good. Rebound Bears. Schmidt not having a good night either.
Yeah, he's a little bit out of sorts. He's not putting himself in a position to actually make a shot. He's either under the rim, behind the backboard, or double covered.
Bounce pass underneath to McGackey. He turns, spins, right hand hook off the glass. Oh, baby. No, that was Jodry. Jodry makes it look good. Here comes Jack. He pulls up, shoots, blocked shot. Linganore ball. So Jack has his shot blocked.
Yeah, 39-39. Who'd have thought we'd have been in this situation late in the game here?
39 apiece.
Oh, look at that! You're not going to believe what just happened. Thomas Lang threw the ball off an Oakdale player on purpose, picked it off his back, stood up and shot it in for the score.
Again, defensive breakdown and a smart basketball player inbounding the basketball.
What a heads-up inbound. And now a steal by Carter Schmidt. He hits the line. Oh, sorry, Carter. And chest bump from Lang. Lang says, let's go. Let's go.
And again, Schmidt still hustling. But again, in the wrong place. It's just it's one of those nights for him, I think.
41-39, Linganore on top. Oakdale has the ball. And there's the inbound to Desioro. Desioro brings it up slowly at midcourt. Down on the left side. Jodry, he drives the paint. Bounce pass. Over to, no, that is just, shot! Oh, that right-hander is going every time. For Schley
on the play there.
Back the other way. Carter, Boutlet to Lane. Lane shoots and scores.
Good interior passing by Carter there. Excellent pass to Keegan Lane.
They trade buckets. Linganore maintains the lead. Oakdale has the ball. McGackie brings it up midcourt. McGackie directs traffic. Clears him out on the right side. Down on the right to Jodry. Jodry, he directs traffic. They set the screen. Nothing there. Back to Desioro. He goes up with the right. Left-hander putback is good. So Schley with a putback. Lang has a tie game, 43 apiece. Lang with a double pump move, goes to the hoop, and he's fouled. That one's going to go on McGackie, and this is going to send Thomas to the line to shoot two.
And he's playing like a man possessed. He's the one out there that just wants that frenetic pace. He wants to attack
you'd
the
swear
basket.
You'd swear this was a playoff game, wouldn't you?
Absolutely. Hits the first one.
And now Desioro back in the game now as Foster takes a rest. Lang makes them both. Timeout, Linganore.
60 seconds.
So we got a 60-second timeout.
45-43, Linganore by two.
4:27 to go here. And again, when you looked at it on paper before the game, you had a team that was giving up more points than they were scoring in Oakdale. And you had a team that was putting 69 points on the board every night and only giving up 46. And again, the community rivalry, none of these kids on either side of this court want to lose to one another. They want bragging rights right here in their home community, and they're going to play like that.
Unlike football, which is a team sport, basketball is all about the matchups. And right now, Oakdale's taking advantage of the matchups. Schley having a lights-out game. Staub, Schmidt, and, you know, a couple of his teammates are a little bit cold.
Yeah, I mean, Thomas Lang is single-handedly keeping him in this game. And he wants the basketball. And you'll love to see that in a kid playing a sport like this, that he wants the basketball.
Right.
The other interesting thing is, with all that going on, Linganore's still in the basketball game.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's two different styles. There's the frenetic pace of Linganore, and then there's the slow-down patience of Oakdale, moving the ball around and trying to get it inside to Schley or McGackie.
And with all that going on, remember, Linganore was down most of the second half. They battled back to take the lead now. Oakdale with the ball. Desioro brings it up midcourt, guarded by Little Lang. Nicholas guards him up. Then he passes off. Schley posts out front. Schley bounces one and passes to McGackie. McGackie penetrates. Kicks it out in the corner. Blocked. And now there's a whistle.
Yeah, McGackie was out of bounds when he hit the ball.
Yep. Linganore ball.
Coach Connolly doesn't like that. He's pleading with the official. Come on.
Lang brings it up. Between the legs. Shake and bake. Kicks it out. They run an offense. Working that perimeter. Nicholas penetrates. Bounce pass underneath the lane. Lane spins. Goes up and he shoots. And he steps on the line, so they call out of bounds on Lane now. Oakdale
yeah,
ball.
Either stepped out of bounds or he moved his feet a little too much, too. Either way, it was going to get called.
Well, he got caught too far underneath the glass. He was going to have a difficult shot one way or the other. Oakdale has it down by two with 3:36 to go in the game. On the right side, bounce pass underneath. Stolen away, Lane. Staub has it. Lang and Staub. Lang goes up. Staub goes up, misses. putback is good.
And there's Connor Schmidt. Carter Schmidt in the right place this time. Put the ball back up. Lingenor's up four with 3:18 to go here.
Carter Schmidt wipes the glass clean and puts it back in for the score. And now Oakdale down by four. Biggest lead of the second half. Schmidt ties him up, and then Schmidt draws the foul. That's going to send, I believe, McGackey to the line to shoot the bonus.
Yet again, it got a little bit too aggressive on that play there. Something like that's going to get called when you got to fight for the ball like that. If you get it clean, that's one thing.
Swish! McGackey hits the front end. 47-44, Lingenor by three. McGackey with a chance to trim that to two on this bonus. And he does. Lane, inbound to Lang. Lang brings it up right side. Slows it down in the right corner of the front court. Directing traffic, Lang trying to isolate. Cross court to Nicholas. Nicholas posts Lane up. Way down on the corner to Staub. Staub kicks it out to Lane. Lane shoots
and
a five.
And that's what they need
score.
To do. Great ball movement on that to get an easy shot for Keegan Lane just inside the key.
Working against that zone defense, they hit the soft spot and score. 49-45, 2:31 to go. Oakdale, drive to the hoop. There's a whistle before the shot.
Yeah, and they're
going to
call Carter Schmidt on
that. Again, we're
going to
go to the line. This time, we're in double bonus, and it's going to be Schley. Or is it McGackey? McGackey at the line. Those cotton picking Oakdale uniforms have black letters on black uniforms with white piping. It's impossible to see the numbers. Oh, it rims in and out.
A rare miss for these Oakdale Bears. They're pretty good from the foul line.
McGackey,
you got to play defense with your feet.
Got it.
Playing defense with your hands, it's going to lead to fouls like they just got there at Carter Schmidt.
Lang has it with a three-point lead.
Quick.
He goes straight at the defense, and they call the foul on McGackey. So Lang's going to take a trip to the free throw line now.
And he's going to continue to attack. I mean, he's been successful at it all game long. And like we said earlier,
right.
A lot of his teammates aren't having the nights they normally do, so he's putting a lot of it on the shoulders, and he's stepping up to the challenge.
Yeah. Lang hits the first one. Four-point lead now. Lang wants to make it five. Biggest lead of the game if he does. And then rims in and out. Rebound Oakdale. So it's 50-46. Lingenor by four. 2:17 to go in the game. And Jesse Oro has the ball for the Bears. Down on the left side to McGackey. McGackey looking for the screen from Jodry. They relax it. Over to Jodry as he posts out. Jodry, one bounce, cross court to Schley. Schley taking his time, drives the paint, pulls back, shoots a fade, whiffs nothing but net. Beautiful shot by Corey Schley on a 10-foot fadeaway jumper from the baseline.
Yet again, Coach Conley really whining a lot tonight. I don't know what he's whining about on that play. His guy hit the baseline fadeaway jumper.
I think he thinks he was fouled on the shot. He's ragging all over the ref.
Yeah, he was straight. He went straight up, and Schley actually faded away. There was no contact on that. But again, Schley has got some excellent touch for a big guy, and he's keeping them in this game. 50-48.
Here. Absolutely.
Lingenor holding on to a 2-point lead as we go into a timeout. And Lingenor will have the basketball out of the timeout. So both teams in the bonus. Every foul sends somebody to the free throw line.
Both teams huddle up in front of their respective benches. Both stands pretty much filled here on this Tuesday night arena basketball. I want to take this opportunity to thank Athletic Director at Lingenor High School, Coach Sonny Joseph, for allowing us to broadcast this game here. Great to be back at Lingenor.
So both teams break the huddle here. And Oakdale's not going to apply any pressure on the inbound pass. They're going to all fall back to half court. Let Lingenor bring the ball up, and it's going to be in Lang's hands.
1:48 to go in the game. Lang has the ball on a 2-point lead. He drives the left side, bounce pass to the left wing to Schmidt. Schmidt brings it around to the right side, looks at Staub, and then comes around. They weave it to Lang. Lang behind the back, between the legs. He drives, pulls up, kicks it out to Schmidt.
They're really working that ball. They're running a stall, essentially. They're not looking to shoot. They're trying to draw the foul, I believe. Lang out front, guarded by Jodry. Jodry not really pressing him hard. A minute 15. There goes Lang. He's got the break. He goes to the lane and shoots on the finger roll.
Played right in their hands. As soon as Coach Conley said, come on out, play defense. Lang blew right by him to the basket.
He lulled him to sleep. They thought, and then it, like a lightning bolt, he went straight to the hoop. 52-48. 4-point lead for Lingano with 53 seconds. Oakdale needs to score quickly. Bounce pass underneath, tipped away on the line. Lingenor steps out. Almost stolen by Lingenor. It'll be Oakdale ball underneath their own basket.
Yeah, stop on the baseline. Almost had it. Stepped out of bounds. Good defensive play there. 46.4 seconds to go and a 4-point lead for Lingenor.
Bounce pass underneath. Almost stolen again. Shot off the glass. No good. Rebound. Jack Staub rips it away. Here come, and there's a foul in the backcourt. They foul Nicholas Lang, and they'll walk the length of the floor where young Nick will shoot the 1-1 with his team up by 4 and 38 seconds on the clock.
And this is going to be the game. This is going to be it. They're going to get fouled every time now because Oakdale literally wants to stop the clock. Every time they stop the clock, they're playing against two opponents, Lingenor and the clock. Down by 4. Nicholas Lang coolly hits the first one. Up 5, 53-48 here with 38 seconds to go.
Lang to shoot one. Short off the front rim. Rebound, Carter Schmidt gets it to Lingenor. And now they have to foul again. And they foul Nicholas again. Or is it timeout?
Timeout, Lingenor.
All right,
full
no foul
timeout,
on that
60
one.
Second timeout.
Lingenor calls a timeout.
And up again, five. Carter Schmidt, we talked about earlier, he just seemed like he was always in the wrong place. But his hustle's now putting him in the right place late in this game, and he's made a couple key plays. That rebound's
back.
Huge.
Yeah. He just went up there and took that thing, put it right off the glass on the putback. And that was huge because that was the one that split the game out to a 4-point lead.
And now Lingenor holding on to a 5-point lead here, and they're going to take the ball out of bounds. Look for him to get it into Lang's hands.
I want to remind you, this game will be archived in its entirety and available on WTHU.org in our audio vault. Just go to our high school basketball link, and you'll see it. We archive it in YouTube, so you'll be able to find the YouTube link right there. Nicholas Lang will inbound from right in front of his own bench with 34.7 seconds on the clock and a 5-point lead. There's the inbound to Lang. Thomas Lang has it. He's fouled immediately.
Fouled right away by Ziegler.
And Lang looks like he might have gotten dinged on that one a bit.
Yeah. Thomas. It looks like like he got it in the sausage and biscuits there.
I think that's what we call a cup injury.
Yeah.
He's bouncing it up. Thomas Lang is holding his cup, standing at the top of the key, bouncing up and down, trying to work that one off, and they call a timeout. And he's still bouncing, man. He got.
I don't think there's any cup about that. I think he got hit in the jewels.
Yeah.
And you could tell by the look on his face. He's
trying
to knock him back down, right?
Yeah, all right. So they call a timeout. They got one to give him a chance to, shake that one off?
Yeah.
All right. Back out on the floor now. 30-second timeout. Again, 32.8 seconds. A 5-point lead. And Lang shoots 1-1 bonus. Make it 6-point lead.
Nothing but net. That didn't even stop him.
No.
So 54-48. 32.8 seconds to go
here. I think it adjusted his shot and made it better.
And Lang shooting the second one.
You got him.
Yeah,
both.
Nothing but net.
Both were Swiss net.
6-point lead here with 32 seconds to go.
Jesse Oro, he drives, kicks it out. Lang tries to steal. Trip on the fly. And I believe, I can't see the number yet.
Yeah, they're going to call that on Lang. I think they just got their feet tangled up.
Believe it or not, that's going to send
number five to the line. That's
Ziegler.
Brandon Ziegler to shoot the 1-1, but that's Lang's first personal. Ziegler
after
misses
that
it.
Whole game, that's his first personal. And as aggressive as he played tonight, that says something.
So a seven-point lead now for Linganore. And they did it all from the free throw line, basically, after they capped that four-point lead. Oakdale with no choice, running out of time. They had to foul to stop the clock.
And Oakdale's basically got one more to go here. And it'd be interesting to see what happens. You know, if Linganore gets the rebound, they're going to get fouled right away.
Absolutely. But down by seven, I mean, it's pretty futile at this point.
Yeah. And still play the game out.
Exactly. All right, Ziegler to shoot one. He throws up a brick on purpose. Linganore rips it down. And then Jack Staub is fouled as he tries to outlet to Nicholas. But they call the foul.
And again, the final 38 seconds here tonight is going to feel like 38 minutes.
Yeah.
Because we're going to get a foul every time we turn around.
Like the last 2 minutes of a football game.
Exactly.
It goes on for half an hour. Swish.
So Staub hits it. Staub been off all night, so it's good for him. Hit one of these free throws and see if he's going to
go.
So get the,
Jack with a nice soft touch slides over the front of the rim and drops through the strings. This one doesn't. This one bounces in and out. Jodry comes up with it. Loses the handle, gets it back, and shoots on the run. No good. He throws up a brick.
Last guy you want to shoot from out there.
Outlet to Lang, and they're going to let it go. That's it. Linganore will take the game and keep their 9-0 win record, unbeaten record, 56-48 here tonight. That's it. There's the buzzer. Chest bumps all over the place. Linganore with an amazing comeback victory over Oakdale here at courtside.
And that says a lot when you got a team like that. Everybody's cold except for your leading scorer, Thomas Lang, who really took the team on his shoulders tonight. But they still win a tough game against a tough team. That says a lot for this team.
No doubt about it. We want to thank our game sponsors for making this one possible. Anytime Fitness of Thurmont, Frederick County Bank, Med One Pharmacy, Shamrock Restaurant, and Thurmont Eye Care. Thanks for sponsoring tonight's game. I'm going to challenge you now, Thomas. Any player of the game selection? We've got a great Wizards shirt to give to the player of the game along with some car washes. What do you think? Who do you...
Are you going to challenge me or are you going to ask me who the player of the game is? Because it's pretty easy.
Is it easy?
It's pretty easy.
How easy
and
is
I think
it?
I think we're going to be in complete agreement here.
Yeah.
I think Thomas Lang took this game over for Linganore.
What can I say?
And I think without him, you're looking at a different outcome.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So the vote has to go to Lang. I don't know how many points he ended up with. He had 8 in the first half, and he was even more dominant in the second half.
Yes.
Great game for Lang, who's bound for Shepherd, I guess, in the fall to play basketball.
Uh-huh.
So that's my vote, Michael. Let me know. Are we on the same page here?
Yeah, I think we are. Yeah. Okay, well, step aside for break. Try to get Mr. Lang over here
Visit
for a little
Shamrock
interview and
today.
Give him his
the
player
Shamrock
of the game.
Is located on Route 15, just a mile north of Thurmont. That's the Shamrock Restaurant for good food and some warm Irish hospitality. Tell them WTHU sent you is more fun than a barrel full of leprechauns. That's the Shamrock Restaurant since 1963. When you mention the mere thought of Ireland in Frederick County, the first thing that springs to mind is the Shamrock Restaurant. Locally owned and operated, the Shamrock Restaurant is a dining legend around the region, featuring Fitzgerald family recipes in the tradition of the Irish countryside. For the Shamrock, it's a continuation of their old country family recipes using fresh, authentic ingredients. Dining in a warm, relaxed atmosphere that you'll remember as a seasonal event, the Shamrock Restaurant, located just north of Thurmont on Route 15. Stop by today and find out why it's the most popular restaurant in our area for over 30 years. The Shamrock Restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
Emerson once said, people only see what they are prepared to see. That's why Thermont Eye Care understands that vision is more than just seeing. It is providing you with professional vision solutions from eyewear to contacts that will help you see better and enhance how people see you. Thermont Eye Care is passionate about providing for all of your vision needs with a caring attitude and a dedicated commitment to serving those who want the best. Conveniently located on the square in Thermont, Maryland, Thermont Eye Care can help you save time and money. Tired of driving all over just to find the right vision care center that can fit your busy schedule? Dr. Molly Karen is a board-certified optometrist with years of experience who understands that your eyesight is a precious gift. See the best. Thermont Eye Care. Located at number 2 East Main Street in downtown Thermont. Walk in or call area code 301-271-0554 for an appointment today. That number again, 301-271-0554.
Hello, my name is William Warren, owner of Emmanuel Technology Consulting. In this rapidly changing world of technology, the last thing you want to do is search for help for all the technology in your life from several different companies. Emmanuel Technology Consulting is experienced in multiple platforms, including smartphones, iPads, Android tablets, and gaming consoles, just to name a few. Data security is a huge issue these days, and you need to protect your data from malware, software corruption, or hardware failure. Emmanuel Technology Consulting is not just about prevention or about proactive intervention when it comes to your important information. When you have a problem, you don't have to wait for a phone call back. We will respond quickly to you, and we are experts at remote diagnostics, so you will have a quick solution. That's Emmanuel Technology Consulting. Call us today at 301-524-5271 or check us out online at etc-md.com. Emmanuel Technology Consulting, helping you design your digital life.
Mount Airy Mattress is not about gimmicks. It's about sleep. They believe they can help you learn how to sleep better. Their family is dedicated to providing you superior service at the best price. That's why they'll donate a portion of your mattress purchase to your favorite charity. Shop at a place that truly cares about you and your sleep. Mount Airy Mattress. See for yourself. Stop by today. Located on East Ridgeville Boulevard, just off Route 27 in Mount Airy. Or call at 301-829-8855. Mount Airy Mattress, your local sleep specialist. Mount Airy Mattress is a proud supporter of Linganore football.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here at courtside. Try to check some scores from around the league for you here. Let's see what we've got. Titans. Tuscarora playing over at Frederick. Trailing by one, entering the fourth period. Middletown, the boys' varsity Knights beat Catoctin Cougars. Basketball 78-54 tonight. And let's see, over in Washington County, Williamsburg at the end of three quarters, leading North Hagerstown 63-30. So we've got Thomas Lang here. Thomas, great game, man. We selected you as player of the game.
Thank you. It means a lot. It was a rough game, but I wanted to beat them more than anything. And
did you?
Got done. Yeah.
It showed. It showed. You guys came out a little flat in the beginning.
We did. We came out a little anxious. I mean, we haven't beaten Oakdale since I've been in high school, since my freshman year on varsity. We've never beaten Oakdale.
Six straight games you've lost to them, yeah. So this was a big, huge game
it's
for
huge.
You emotionally.
We came out very anxious to play.
Uh-huh.
But after a little while, towards the halftime, we were like, you know what? We've been here before. It's time to take care of business and come out and play the way we should play.
What was the turning point in the game for you?
Momentumly, definitely, we were coming down, we were losing by one, and I think Harry Rasmussen, Jack Staub, one of those two, got an and one, and that just put us in the lead, and out, we were off and running from there. And then at the end of the third quarter, when I hit that and one shot, we weren't looking back.
You really had to pick up the slack tonight because Schmidt and Staub were having a tough time from the field.
they pick me up when I have a tough time, so it's my turn to pick them up.
Sure.
It's just we do whatever's best for the team, and that's what we needed tonight. And
absolutely.
So
well, a big win. You guys are undefeated, 9-0 now. Of course, you're going to have to play these guys in exactly a month over at their house.
Yes, we will, and I can't wait.
And this was an unexpectedly very, very good game. We thought it felt like a Friday night game.
I wish it was played on a Friday night so we can go out and have some fun. But you know what? It was a big game, and you have to rise to the challenge. And we did that, and we took care of business.
So congratulations. We selected your leading scorer in the game as our player of the game, and you get a Wizards T-shirt from Kia Motors.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. Also, 4 free car washes there. For you and your family at the Frederick Shell.
Thank you so
much. So congratulations, Thomas Lang, player of the game for Linganore.
Thank you.
We'll see you next week. All right.
We will.
Thanks, Thomas.
Have a good job. Thank you.
All right. We want to thank you, Tom. Tom Jeppy, great game, man. Good to have you back in the booth.
Hey, it was good to be back. It's a lot of fun. It was a good game to be around.
Yeah, it was a great night for basketball.
Oh, yeah. These guys, neither team wanted to lose. As you just talked to Thomas Lang, he took over. He didn't want to lose. Personally, he did not want to lose.
Yeah, we forgot about the history, didn't we?
Oh, yeah. I mean, these kids all grew up playing together a lot of times on the same team. And then when they were younger, everything got split up with the redistricting, and now they're arch rivals. Whereas before, the big rivalry was really Urbana. There's still a rivalry, but this Oakdale rivalry is gaining more strength every year.
Well, speaking of rivalries, we'll be back with you next Friday night over at Urbana High School, where the Hawks are going to take on the Bears. So we'll get to see what the Hawks and Bears have in store for each other. I hope it's as good as we had tonight. It's Friday night in Urbana High School. Tip-off is 7 p.m. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That is a wrap. What a great game. Encourage you to go to the Audio Vault and pull this thing up and listen to it online. Download it to your iPod. Listen to it at your convenience. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you. Have a great rest of your week.